Hey everybody, welcome back to Northern Lion Plays, The Binding of Isaac Rebirth. There's no way on this Lazarus run we are going to match the heights of our last Azazel run, but we do still have the streak alive. This might be, though this and the Eden run are the most pivotal. QZM6RX48. If we can get through this run, I firmly believe that we can beat the next run as Eden. Well, I mean, I shouldn't get too, planny about that, considering we're not even going to know what we had. And the last Eden run that I had, I lost, despite having Sacred Hearts. So clearly, I can just not be trusted. However, what I'm trying to say is, I love you all. Let's move along. But I believe that we can win this Lazarus run, and, you know, the power of positive thinking, man, if we win this Lazarus run, I'm going to be on a high for that Eden run. Eden run. If we win as the Eden character that we spawn as, maybe we will have a good chance to win as Isaac, and then the next time that I'm going to be really concerned is when we get to Maggie. That's not so bad. And then all we got to do is beat the Judas Blue Baby runs, and we're getting all the way back around to Eve, which is the next character. And then after we beat Eve, we can get working on our second cycle, because I think Eve is the first character that we actually won as. Anyway, first item room. Yeah, okay, it's bad. Kane's other eye. I might classify this as one of the worst passive items in the game. Of all of the eye items, and boy, are there a lot of them, this is certainly one of them. I would rather have it than Mom's eye in some situations. It doesn't even do damage when it goes through enemies. At least give it like the Peeper's Eye effect or something like that to compensate for the fact that it is mad because it's bad. Whatever, though. It doesn't really matter. And of course, with Lazarus, I'm looking to, if possible, get ourselves killed as soon as possible. And the way that I'm most likely to make that happen is if we can get a Spirit Heart on this floor, or if we can get an HP upgrade from this boss. Thank you, nearsighted friend. That actually did... You know what? Let's give it the credit where it's due here. Let's give this a try. You hit it once, that'll make my life easier in here. And then you hit that guy once, that makes my life a little easier in here as well. Thank you. And because of our bad luck, I don't have to backtrack through that rock puzzle to get anything. Lucky me, I guess. Maybe Nearsighted Friend has, like, crazy good damage or something like that. Well, no, it doesn't, because it was two-shotting these freaking little baby spiders. I think I'm two-shotting them as well, but maybe it's tied to our own damage stat. I don't know. I'm talking about the power of positive thinking. I'm trying to bullshit my way into actually enjoying Nearsighted Friend here. Probably unlikely to happen. Widow fight, of course, a little bit harrowing with all the stuff, but the boss itself has very low HP. And we do get the blue cap, which is an HP upgrade, so I think it is in our best interest to just end our own lives here. Now, the only thing I want to make sure is that when I end my own life, I'm not on, like, the wrong side of the spikes. You do spawn with a little bit of invincibility, so I think we'll be fine if I just, like, bleh, and then walk over to the right quickly. There we go. That's better. So we're going to have a 1.2 times damage modifier. We now have 0 luck instead of negative luck. We have 2 HP, so I think it's worth it, but it's a bit of a crapshoot, you know. You never really know as Lazarus. I just think that that's, you know, the best practice that you can do most of the time. Now, this is the moment of truth. On the last run, we had so many Spirit Hearts that a deal with the devil... I mean, we're Azazel, so a deal with the devil is basically guaranteed. We're not in that position on this run, unfortunately. We're going to need to not take damage, which is easier said than done. Is there anything that's easier done than said? I guess it's easier to defenestrate something than it is to actually say the word or spell the word defenestration. We're wondering what defenestration means, is just to throw something out a window. It's one of those words that people like to use to make themselves look smart, which is why I just used it right here. But now, whenever someone does that, why do you just say throw it out the window, you freaking Poindexter? And then they'll feel bad about themselves, which is really the goal for, you know, every communication in life is just to get power over the other person you're talking to, right? Right? Am I right? No? Okay, alright, that's fine. You're right. Those people are sometimes dickbags. Anyway, 5 cents does allow us to buy conceivably a Spirit Heart if we could just find our shop at any point in the near future. Don't jump. If you jump, you're lucky I didn't finish that sentence, and as such cannot hold you responsible for your actions quite yet. Come on up here, spider bro. Nearsighted friend just shit on you. How does that feel? Probably not very good if I had to guess. So that one, you know, bastardized meat boy is going to be faster as a result of his gold hue. Just want to keep as far away as possible, because if I get close, you know, he's got a little bit higher movement speed. It could be scary. This is actually pretty good for us here. If of all the floors in the game, this is where we're going to do our most due diligence, just because it makes the biggest difference. We might as well try this. There's a very small chance that we could get a black market or a crawl space. I didn't talk about it, but Halo of Flies in our first or our second item room, I guess, is actually a really good get. The earlier you get defensive items, the better. I mean, the earlier you get any item, the better, but it's easy to make a case for early defensive items because, you know, the damage they save you is basically cumulative. Cumulative. Herald and Cumulative go to Guantanamo Bay. Alright. This means we guilt-free, we can carry the Sun card with us, which is good. It's a full health pill, so if we get super low, we can pop it. Or we could use it as a makeshift compass if we get a teleport card that we'd rather take with us instead. What do you got for me? Justice. Great card. Great card indeed. If we could ever find the Tinted Rocks, I'd feel great, but short of that, it's really us going to our shop and buying a Spirit Heart just to keep the... just to keep the deal with the Devil Dream alive. And the bombs are now out of control, so the hardest boss we can fight here, I think, is Headless Horseman. Given our situation, I think we'd probably be fine. I hate Curse of the Lost, man. Where are we? I guess we go up. There is a double key room that we can access now as well, but I'd rather just use one key to get to our shop. I thought that was a mega fatty for a second and almost literally shit my pants. Not figuratively. I almost defecated in my pants and I would have had to stop the video. Because I was like, man, we're doing decent damage, but not good enough to feel comfortable about fighting mega fatty right now, I'll tell you that much. This room is over. There's our shop. Shop does... Yes, it does have a spirit heart in it. I think this might be a situation in which I'm happy to have a little bit of a nest egg here, because if we just get to 12 cents, which will require another one of these, I can buy the map in addition. Why? I just played it again. What is wrong with me? That should... Yeah, that takes us a little bit higher than we need to go, which is great. That'll allow me to buy the map in addition to getting the spirit heart, which is great. And we still have a number of bombs left over as well. No tinted rocks in this room? That's a surprise to me. This is also an enormous floor. Like, boss rush is something that is probably out of the question for us right now. Maybe the floor is not that big, but I just keep backtracking and causing myself to take a little bit more time than is necessary. You want to see the double key room? I'll show you the double key room. Let's see what we got. It's a six room. Rerolls everything. You know what? There's relatively low consequences to doing this early. Let's try it. Oh, fuck. Loki's horns, Isaac's heart? Are you kidding me? Oh, man. That is so bad. We could really, really... I mean, our tiers are really high here. But we would really benefit from having not done that. Isaac's heart is such a pain in the ass to use. And this is even, like, this is an order of magnitude more difficult than Guillotine. What we gotta do is keep our body in between all enemies and Isaac's heart. But the other thing that we have to do, or the other thing that we can do to make up for it, is just get, like, a mom's knife or something here that gives us incredible damage. And maybe we can get our first win with Isaac's heart. So the real way that I think you're supposed to play this... item is whenever enemies are going to shoot bullets... Obviously, this is going to get harder to do floor by floor. But whenever enemies are going to shoot bullets, you just put your body in front of them. Just. Yeah, you just, you know, go against every instinct that Isaac has ever taught you and put your body in between the bullets and a familiar. Easy. So we get super bandage for some more HP. And Death's Touch. This is a great item. It's not quite great enough to compensate for Isaac's heart, for like just to call this a one run right off the bat, but it is good. All right, never let anybody tell you that Northern Lion doesn't like the zaniness anymore. We were already in a good position as Lazarus. I rerolled everything, and may come to regret this. Ah, that is a crawl space or a black market. It's just a crawl space, man. We've been getting so many crawl spaces in like zero black markets lately. We do have Swallowed Penny, makes money a little bit more likely. Our rate of fire is good. I don't like necessarily having Fear Shot, but it's not the end of the world. Yeah, teleport me, give me some Spirit Arts. Oh, a free item! 9 lives is actually great for us in this situation. So yes, you know, there's a way out for us if we become Guppy. This is you'd think that Isaac's Heart would be like a dream item for me, because I'm always using orbitals. This gives me a chance to finally, you know, become an orbital, and the orbital I've always wanted. One that I can control completely. It's hard to get used to, though. You know, it's not so bad. I will say, you know, enemies that chase you strike me as maybe the most annoying enemies we could possibly fight, because we've got to get Isaac's Heart, like, really out of the way, and it has a little bit of a lag time because it follows you in the same way that a familiar does, so... Yeah, my number one defense to bullets is to, like, back up and then choose where to go. And that doesn't work when you're rolling with Isaac's Heart, because when you back up, you make it as vulnerable as possible. Pentagram. Great item. We, don't have the map anymore, of course. You guys ever see the Sinbad movie, First Kid? That's how I feel right now, man. We gotta be ready to jump in front of these bullets. We're very lucky. I mean that sincerely. Sure, that's all right. Although, does that even help with Isaac's Heart? I imagine that probably does not help with Isaac's Heart at all, now that I think about it. We gotta be ready to jump in front of these bullets, man. And it's only gonna get harder and harder when we start facing enemies that have beams, for example. Not beans, that's very different. The devil. That's all right. We also found our second secret room. I actually really appreciate that. I should be able to walk over these spikes, right? Yeah, okay, to get a stars card. What's our other one? The devil? Stars card could allow us to do boss rush. I think we're gonna say fuck it and we're gonna start using this as a bank. Oh my god. Which makes me a straight up hypocrite because I said that the bank was not that important. I am very, very pleased to have curse immunity though. That's awesome. I don't know if we need anything else on this floor, but I guess we'll explore just because it's more practice on an easier floor. That could come in handy. What a weird run that I'm not an enormous fan of, but at the same time, if it helps me get some practice with Isaac's Heart in a relatively safe environment, and if it helps me continue the streak, all is forgiven. But it, you know, using Isaac's Heart goes against every rational bone in my body. Get yourself hurt! Oh, shit. Yeah, that's alright, that's alright. Little bit of damage. Loki's horns almost saved me there. I really can't believe that we had like 5 items, and I re-rolled all the items. We got 2 of my least favorite items in the game. We should use our sun card if we're... I used our stars card by accident. Oh. That's alright, we weren't gonna go to boss rush anyway. Let's be happy that we have a sun card. Sloppy play, I'll admit. So yeah, actually, it kind of turns a little bit of the meta on its head. You might think that enemies like the bonies might be a lot easier to not get hit by because they attack in pretty much a straight line. These enemies, these are the ones I'm worried about. Not so much the chub ones, but the ones that have beams. Because again, with a little bit of a lag time on Isaac's Heart movement, I'm a little concerned. But hey, here we are. We have another pheromones pill, but we'll take the sun with us. And honestly, you know, free pentagram on this floor is pretty good. We actually gained a little bit of HP. I'm still very nervous about how this run scales into the late game, but we should have a good chance of getting a deal with the devil on the next floor. And if we get a deal with the devil, who knows? Basically, we're just stacking up damage at this point in the hopes of making it nearly impossible for Mom's Heart to get hit. Or Isaac's Heart to get hit. If you're wondering why we still have Halo of Flies, I believe that guppy items and fly items do not get rerolled. That's why we still have 9 lives as well. So this is pheromones. I don't think pheromones is particularly useful against Mega Fatty. I mean, we do create dips and stuff like that, but... Figure maybe this... Yeah, don't back up. Don't back up. Again, it goes against every, you know, instinct in the body. Oh, come on. That hit me? Like, from above? I find that a little surprising. We can use pheromones. We might as well use pheromones here. Like, if you're creating an enemy, yeah. Again, those, like... Enemies with high shot speed are going to be probably by far the worst. But if I just stand in front of the shots, I can get around it. But I am a little skeptical of our chances here. On paper, with the items we have, if you got rid of Isaac's Heart, I would be singing my praises right now. I'd be so ready to just call this a one run. Because the game's not played on paper, and we do have Isaac's Heart, I thought for sure I got in the way of that one in time, even though I did admittedly try to run away from it at first. Because the game's not played on paper, we're in a bit of a trickier spot. Oh, no. No. I actually thought about picking it up there for a second. Because I thought it would be funny to say no a bunch of times and then actually pick it up. Like, this room can suck it, as far as I'm concerned. Like, we'll just exit and then try to run our way down, because I didn't trust being able to get Isaac's heart out of the way in time. Infestation is okay. At best. If we just stand, like... That's the thing, man. You gotta have no fear on this run. You gotta stand, like, right in the path of the bullets. That's the safest place for you to be. How messed up is that? It's very difficult to adjust to playing like that. At least we didn't end up with, like, one more terrible item could have killed us. If we had gotten soy milk or something, I would be like, ugh, yuck. I'll have the crab juice, but... Good. Stood right in the path there. I think that helped out. We're up to 15 cents again. If we could go to our shop, that'd be nice. Guppy! Okay, we're gonna be fighting Krampus. Beams will still hurt. Sticks and stones will break my bones, but the beams can still freaking hurt me. That's my bad. Right there. What do I want here? I want my fly to get some damage done. Oh my god, I thought I got in the way of that one as well. I guess I'm happy with Krampus' head because we weren't holding a spacebar item anyway. And this will allow us to do things like kill bosses faster. That's meaningful. Yep, not surprised I didn't get out of the way of that one. That one's my bad. Good. Fear shot helped out a lot there. Tears down. Hurts. Hurts a little bit. You can see we're starting to erode our HP. That's not the position I'd like to be in. Enemies that don't shoot bullets and are fast are the biggest pain in the ass. This is perfect. Thank you for the proper timing there. Yeah, we gotta take this. There's something to be said about magic fingers here. I don't think we need the coin purse. Magic fingers is kind of tempting. Anything that allows us to kill enemies faster. Oh. I was so in that until the last minute. At just like the last possible second, I was like, back up, back up, back up. I gave in to my animal instincts, and I took damage as a result. Remember, we are the shield. We're not the sword. We're the shield. Oh, man, that was close. All right. Judgment. Interesting. I want to pop this judgment, like, back in this room so that we don't have to walk through it. All right, I'm going to play you. I would love to have some HP and be able to trade that HP away for the ability to become Guppy. We really need a couple of things. We need, like, the ability to fly, Guppy. I mean, obviously, a lot of these kind of tie into one another, but anything along those lines would be awesome. Oh, this is so good. Okay. So my thinking, that was not very smart of me. My thinking is we kill the first phase of the Fallen, and then we go Krampus' head, and we get the Razor Blade. Wow. Not at all what I was looking for. It's okay. We've been to our item room, we've been to our shop, I'd say we go down to the next floor. Still, Krampus' head by itself, a great pickup for us. Apologies, I had to adjust my microphone there. Yeah, well, because there's a red chest, we'll open it, and I regret it. Yeah, we couldn't get Guppy's head out of the way in time. This is a bit of a moment of truth. I'm a little bit scared. I'm also worried about these wall masters, but I think we have the speed necessary to get away, as long as I am somewhat intelligent in my dodges, which is debatable. You guys shoot bullets, so I'm gonna... Yep, blocked it. Blocked it! Almost got hit, but didn't have to worry about it. No Guppy items, huh? I fucking hate those things. Just tell you that straight up. Ha, da, 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 da. It's not my favorite run right now. It's amazing how much more amazing this run would be if I had just not gone to the reroll room. But it was a 6, so it might have rerolled our devil room and given us Death's Touch instead of Brother Bobby or something, but still. At the very least, you see some interesting play here. If I can get to Blood Banks, we can play the Blood Banks endlessly. I understand that stuff. I understand that we can play Demon Judgments endlessly as well. Oh, I get it, so I can get hurt, but I don't know what I'm trying to say. I'm indignant, though. So, like, the Wall Masters, if they touch me, I get hurt, but if they touch Isaac's heart, let me guess, they also get, or we also get hurt. What is this? Necropolis 1? You know what? Maybe I should stop complaining about not being able to go to the arcades when I'm not looking for the fucking arcades, right? That's on me. Some people think, oh, Northern Lion's blind to his own idiocy. That's not true. I see it. I just, I beat myself up over it just in a different way. If you think you're the Isaac's Heart Master, by all means, man. Play the seed along with me. I mean, your reroll will probably be different, but go ahead, you know? Teach me your tips. I'd love to get better. War. Not so bad. If I can just... Like, his bombs are going to be the worst. But if I can just get him to the position where he's chasing us down, then pop Krampus's head, he should die. He'll be chasing us soon, especially because of that bomb, and then Krampus's head finishes the job. We did get a deal with the devil. This is where the dreams live or die. Yeah, okay, so we'll take Gimpy. And we'll take the Pact. And we still have 9 lives, so it's a little bit of a damage upgrade. It's good. Not quite a coup of staggering value, but our damage is nice. Pin? Oh no, bunch of these guys and pin. Okay. Where's my pins at? Ah! I did not expect that. Polycephalus strikes me like a relatively annoying enemy because I have the tendency to get pretty close to him. His bullets are... Actually, you know what? If his bullets are hard to avoid, maybe that's a good thing, because it makes it easier for me to hit them. And hopefully harder for Isaac's heart to get hit by them. This run is all about bragging rights at this point. If I can actually make this happen, I would be thrilled. And I'd feel pretty good. You know, Sissy Longlegs is a good item. No question about that one. And the dream lives. Okay, so we can play Blood Banks and it shouldn't hurt me. Yeah, okay, the dream is real again. I don't really care. We don't have any Whore of Babylon action or anything like that going on right now, so to get a blood bag is good. We can trade that away for more HP in the future, maybe. Permanent Polaroid Invincibility is going to come in handy, probably. We should have enough money on this floor. Oh, does that mean... Yeah, I can go into Curse Rooms for free as well. Okay. I mean, some people have been under the assumption that I didn't understand Isaac's Heart, and there might have been some intricacies I don't understand about Isaac's Heart. That's pretty good. I would definitely agree with you on that one. However, I understood that the drawback... was, you know, it's harder to dodge stuff, and the advantage is that the body is immune. It was never like, oh, I don't really get it. Well, I guess like the first time I got it, I was like, I don't really get it. But since then, I've understood it. It's just I don't really appreciate it. Not every item in Isaac deserves appreciation. We're immune to creep as well, so it's basically like a permanent callus trinket along with the added value of being able to play like Blood Banks. Infinitely. It's good. Except for the fact that it makes dodging very, very difficult. Case in point. But Gimpy did pay out with the Spirit Heart there. That's the value of Gimpy. Now, Gimpy is an item where the truism is very much true. The earlier you pick it up, the much better it is for you. Because it can really generate Spirit Hearts at half cost. We'll take this because why not, right? We already played our Blood Bank. Tarot cards? Nah, probably not. And, let's just do this. I don't know what that pill is. I don't really care. Save our money. You never know. Maybe we come across more judgments later in the game. Boss rush is not going to happen. We still have our sun card for full HP, and we're down to the next floor. We keep getting stronger from floor to floor, which is the way that it should go. So I'm happy about it. Depths? Straight up on the depths. I wonder if we could reroll our whole run again. No, just a... Three Skull Monty. I'll blow him up to try to get some of our investment back there. Well, we got our investment in blowing him up back. Can't go in there. And I don't know if we'll ever be able to go in there, to be honest with you, because I have almost no means to hurt myself. Normally, you'd expect to maybe... The only thing that we could do it with is a deal with the devil, basically, I guess. Instead of getting out of the way of that bullet, I should have gotten in the way of the bullet. Again, I can't stress enough that this is hard to get used to. Did I get hit twice there? How did that happen? Maybe only once. Maybe I'm just crazy. You're gonna shoot, so I should be ready for that bullet. Yeah, and just absorb it. Very strange situation to find ourselves in. 38 cents, money equals power. You know, coming to the point where it's one of the upgrades I'd be thinking about the most. We'll shoot these fires, because I don't trust myself to be able to get through them. Don't jump. Don't jump. Good stuff. Well... Certainly a more interesting Lazarus run than I'd anticipated for myself. We can't do that. I'm sorry. We've hit our quotient for crazy, and I can't afford to take dark matter. It's just gonna get me killed, in my opinion. Yeah. Oh, this is so good. Okay, so free Demon Judgment play. If you could give me a key in the process, that'd be awesome as well. But for now, I'm content to play the shit out of you. I found pills, not that good. Just make sure Isaac's heart doesn't run into him. I doubt that does anything, but... Alright, speed plus range. It's something, at least. With 10 bombs, there is a chance that this is our secret room right here. Okay. So if we want to get into our shop, we're going to have to earn a key the old-fashioned way. That is not going to do it, but the money's really good. But the money's not worth anything if we can't actually get a key. Now, I don't want to... There we go. I don't want to get you too excited, but if we do end up beating this run, I think this will be the first run I've ever had where I've won with Isaac's heart. And I'm very much not getting ahead of myself because it's not even necessarily likely, even though it might seem like we're super powerful right now. Once we get down to the next floor and start facing, you know, harder enemies who also hit for double damage, things are going to become a little bit more stressful for me. But it would be a milestone, that's for sure. Take these flies into the mom fight. That'll help us speed things up just a little bit. And, of course, we'll try that out. That worked pretty well. And, you know, we've got a good... Yeah, I'm not surprised about that. We got a good amount of damage from our tears as well. It's going to make this fight pretty easy. No deal with the devil, but we got two spirit hearts at the end of it. And we'll be heading down to the next floor. And, you know, not only is this... Oh, tinted rock. Not only is this the... This would be the first runner I've ever won with Isaac's heart. This is the furthest we've ever been with Isaac's heart. So it's going all right for me already. I already consider this like a small victory. If those were red chests, I'd be all over it. As a golden chest, there's nothing I can do whatsoever. So, not so bad. And admittedly, you know, as much as I've shit-talked Isaac's heart, I will tell you straight up, there are some enemies that Isaac's heart seems advantageous to fight with. Or, like, there's some enemies for which I'd rather have Isaac's heart than not. Bonies, it seems like Isaac's heart is actually a nice pickup there. Any enemy that rushes you down, or particularly any enemy that shoots an area of effect attack like bombs, no. No thank you. This would be Pin, it's gotta be. There's no space for Polycephalus to be here. Another thing that might be great for us, and you know, we're in full-on theory crafting. I thought I had Guppy's head, I swear to God, I'm an idiot. We're in full-on, like, theory crafting territory here. But another thing that might be awesome is, like, Midas Touch. So for enemies that chase me... Oh, good block. I could stand still. Nod Leaf would turn on. Whether or not Nod Leaf is actually advantageous for us remains to be seen. And then we would have Midas Touch do some damage to them. Could be good. Could be meaningless. This is, like, my nightmare room. Stay as far away as possible, please. Good. Fear Shot is like the hard counter to Gertie Jr. I like it. And there's some rooms where I'd much rather not have Fear Shot, as I've said on numerous occasions. Anyway, the best thing that we can do is just get ourselves in there, block that shot, and honestly, I think we're doing pretty well. Yeah, oh, you know what? I'd much rather have Isaac's Heart for doppelgangers. That seems awesome. For these guys, though, I don't think I got hit there. I should have been hit there, but I don't think I got hit there. No tinted rocks. Unfortunately. These guys. For the red ones, I would rather have Isaac's heart. For the green ones, I would much rather have Isaac's heart. On average, I'd rather not have Isaac's heart, but hey. It's the situation we're in. It's what Isaac's all about, man. We gotta learn to live with it. Very easy fight because of Krampus's head. A deal with the devil. Magic mushrooms, so good here. I'm starting to believe in the dream, to be honest with you. And our damage is good, so I think we actually should roll with Satanic Bible, to be honest with you. It did cost us some HP in the process. There's a Tinted Rock here as well. For once, I'm actually doing okay about spotting those. Got an extra Spirit Heart out of it. That Magic Mush pickup is enormous, though. Whether you took Krampus's head or Satanic Bible there, I think you're right. Either way, you know, no matter what you did, whatever you're most comfortable with is acceptable. There are some benefits, though, to taking Satanic Bible and losing the HP. This is one of them. We can come into this room. Now, we did get Guppy's Paw out of it. And to be honest with you, I think... Oh, our damage is so good. I think it's in our best interest to take Guppy's Paw and use it. Get permanent Polaroid invincibility. I hope that applies to Isaac's heart. Sometimes you'd be surprised. That also gives us two Guppy items. There's a realistic chance that we become Guppy on this run. And you might be thinking I'm sandbagging. You might be thinking, oh, Northern Lion, look at your damage. There's no way you're going to lose this run. I'm starting to agree with you, and I take no pleasure in being the guy who's like, oh, I don't know, this run can still go off the rails. That's why I've started trying to call one run, so it's not like, you know, I'm trying to build up any bullshit drama or anything like that. If there's no drama in the run, that's fine, you know? That's Isaac, man. Sometimes you just get carried. I'm hesitating to say that we're carried here just because I've had Isaac's heart a couple of times, and every time I've had it, I've gotten myself fucked by it, basically. But this might be the exception rather than the rule. Okay, new pill, the white one here. It's not that bad. In the whole scheme of things, you know, I'm not gonna go on a long tangent about how our luck stat affects our chances of victory, considering that we've got bigger fish to fry on this run. Man, it must suck to be a small fish, you know? If you're a big fish, do we need a speed upgrade or do we need Swallowed Penny? I mean, they're both kind of useless for us, I guess. If you're a small fish, they still caught you. They didn't say, hey, it's a small fish, throw it back. They said, we got bigger fish to fry. Not only they catch you, they don't even want to eat you afterwards. What's the point? Seems like a total waste. So there's another black heart for us. Which means if we get an HP upgrade here, we don't really need to use Guppy's Paw on it if we don't want to. We could. You know, I think we're better off with the goat head. Or goat hoof, sorry, for the speed upgrade. I get those two confused linguistically a lot. The bean, doesn't really matter if we pick it up, but we're not going to keep it either way. That was very poor damage on my part right there. That's okay, though. Let's move it along. Okay, I hate that shit. But Gimpy worked out very nicely for us right there. Again, I don't really know if permanent Polaroid invincibility applies to Isaac's heart. But we're going to be the best shield that we can possibly be here. I wish there was a rule where, like, Isaac's heart just decided to stay, like, a few steps away from you at all times instead of being right effing next to you. Come on, now. So, I think I'm going to use the sun card. I think I'm going to use the sun card here. Just to see where our boss room is. And this should be a much easier fight for us. That was really bad of me. This should be a much easier floor for us. Because I can just bomb straight through here. Then we'll get to the chest, and the chest is going to be a crapshoot, don't get me wrong. But if we get good items, you know, that's the only thing that really matters. And that's a very easy room for us, and let's fight Isaac here. What an interesting situation. Now, the beams of light from heaven, I have no idea how we're going to dodge those. I don't think I can block them just by, like, standing under them. The good news is the bullets that he fires are completely meaningless. I can just get myself up. Okay, get in here, Isaac. Get in here. The other thing I'm thinking is that pretty much we've just got to be, like, as quick as possible killing him. Because getting it out of the way of the beams is going to be real tricky. But it seems to be working pretty well thus far, actually. That was actually a surprisingly easy fight. I have high hopes for this run if we can just get through to Blue Baby. And that's debatable because we're going to be fighting probably a lot of beam-based enemies here. Double adversary. For example, damage, prayer card, Little Haunt, Anarchist Cookbook. Hey, we got Little Haunt and a damage upgrade in the form of Blood of the Martyr. That's all right in my book. Daddy Longlegs, like, my least favorite enemy to be fighting right now. Least favorite kind of enemy to be fighting. Not my least favorite enemy. Because he doesn't fire bullets. Now, the Gurglings do fire bullets, but it's kind of like their secondary attack. Not surprised we took damage there. At least we found a dead end quickly. Satanic Bible, don't fail me now. Normally, locomotion is the enemy on an Isaac's hard run, I think. You want to stand still and tank the shots. But I wanted to keep moving just because there was so much shit in the way. That's a tough room for us there. I'm not that disappointed with our damage there. It happens. Probably doesn't matter who we kill here. Greed might be the easiest for us, though, because we can just stand in front of the shots. A few bombs. Might come in handy. So the Dark One. How do I feel about the Dark One? They actually are obscuring my vision a little bit here. I'm very lucky to have gotten in the way of that shot. Very lucky to have not gotten hit until the very end there. Let's be honest. I deserve to take the hit there. And this is, of all the runs where I've ever said, you know, it's harder to fight the rooms before the boss than it is to fight the boss, this is, like, the exact example. This is the prototypical example. Every room is a crapshoot. The boss, I think, is actually not going to be that bad at all. These enemies are going to be annoying, but the fact that they create bomb flies does make my life easier. It's actually the Terra Toma that's going to be a little trickier. Good stuff. You know, this is not an achievement on the order of magnitude of, like, my lost runs or anything like that. Not that, oh, look at me, I beat the lost, huh, big man. No, but this is not, like, the greatest achievement I've ever had in Rebirth, but it's nice to get this one off of my chest, you know, and be like, hey, we are going to win a run with Isaac's Heart. This is just empowering because now we know if we get Isaac's Heart, there's a chance we can survive. It's probably not a good chance, but there's a chance. Not just survive, but thrive. But a lot of this is Magic Mushroom, the Pact, you know, stuff like that. Yeah, fuck this room. But fear. The fear shot, man. Oh, well. That's okay. That's okay. Fear shot and Little Haunt do counter Gertie, but we couldn't get all of them at the same time. I couldn't get all of them at the same time. You might find yourself in a very different environment. Yep. Not surprised we got hit there. That's going to happen from time to time. Satanic Bible's ready to go. Get out of there. Get out of there. Okay. I know I'm leaving, like, some bombs behind. I have a feeling it just doesn't matter. I hate this, though. The curved shots are, like, public enemy number one after beams. How am I supposed to block these curved shots, man? Yeah, Leaper got us. Again, when we move, it takes a second for... yeah, fuck you. I'm not fighting Mega Satan on this run. When we move, it takes a second for Isaac's Heart to also, you know, agree with us, for that movement to transfer there. So it's difficult for me to dodge enemies that teleport. Blue Baby might be similar, but Blue Baby doesn't dodge that close to us, so should be okay. The scythes are going to be an absolute pain in the dick, unless we kill them ourselves without even noticing, which is what's happened thus far, thankfully. Oh, yep. Again, fast enemies are our biggest problem. Ah, okay, so one greed fight. Well, against very many greeds, but one greed fight. Thank you, Gimpy, for basically making that damage for free. If I can just stand in front of them. No, oh, I got out of the way of that one, but Gimpy hooked us up again. That Gimpy pickup's so huge. Money, not necessary. Let's do this shit, Blue Baby. I'm ready. So you, like, move away and then get real close. Little Haunt, Sissy Long Legs, the dream is reality. Oh, even the curve shots can't get through. He's moving away from me. That's how you know he's screwed. We're going to win this run. That is exciting. So the Eden run now becomes the crux of completing the cycle here, I think. At least the most unlikely crux of completing the cycle. Great run. Had a good time as Lazarus in spite of the fact that we picked up Isaac's Heart, and that was great. Thanks for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the episode. If you did, click the like button. It helps out a great deal. Of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. For now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.